MTV definitely get they rock on.
Y'all know we down with this rock thing, 9-6 flavor death row.
But who knew it would last, this West Side staff?
But we gonna keep it real, peace in 9-6.
Bring on the nominees and the noise.
If you mainstream, hardcore rap, or R&B, it doesn't matter what, we can all be in the same position at any given time. And they show it to us at every instance. They show you that. They will snatch you up out of your career, out of your good life, and put you on court and make you fight for your life.
My name is Tupac, T-U-P-A-C. She's in the foreground, not in the back, helping the revolution. She was in the front, the one holding the gun in the front of the line.
It was like working with the president. You know, it was big. You know what I'm saying? It was big. It was cool. I walked away with a good experience. I can't say I didn't. I enjoyed her. She's very beautiful. You know, my tongue will never be the same. We kicked it, you know, but I went into the movie saying, you know, in order for me to do this right, I gotta really, truly, indeed fall in love with Janet Jackson. And I did that. I still believe that I did that. I really did fall for it. And when the movie was over, it was like we broke up. You know, and I felt her not being. After they see it and wait for a while, they can go, that was a love story. That was like Romeo and Juliet, you know, but for black. Just look at it, you know, little ghetto gutter kid, rich Janet Jackson. We do a movie together, you know? Yeah, I mean, you can't get no more West Side Story than
the studio. So we go to the studio. That's when Pac did hit him up.
Hey, get this on tape. All of y'all motherfuckers, fuck you. Die slow, motherfucker. My 4-4 make sure all y'all kids don't grow.
Hey, blue suit wearing motherfuckers. We're making a bus here, man. My guys are highly trained professionals, man.
Action move.
What's up? This is Tupac coming at you. Fat for 93 with a fat album strictly for my niggas. Watch it. In the stores, I'm bummed. I done had 4 drinks and 4 blunts. I'm at Snoop Doggy Dog Party, and it's going on with my partners from the Evil Mind Gangsters, and right here with Black Watch. Right here.
So everybody smoke what they love, so they up so. All through high school, girls by the dozen, saying we cousins, knowing that we wasn't. But like the old saying goes, time goes on, and every
all these bitches, and it's just the chemist.
That's to the 9-4. Thug life in this motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Blowing the fuck up. I got my nigga Richie Rich in this motherfucker. You show these motherfuckers what's really going on.
Let me tell you about this thug life shit before you start the next music. Thug life is not what these white folks is trying to paint it to be. I'm not telling niggas to go kick sisters in the ass and, you know, just cause ruckus. I'm just saying, for all you broke niggas, we don't have to be broke no more in 94. If we all got together and used the fear that these white people have for us any motherfucking way, we might have something. One nigga can't do shit, but a million niggas will run this motherfucking country. Yeah. We want this motherfucker. Just like it's niggas in New York, it's niggas in Texas, it's niggas in Oakland, we're all ripping this whole motherfucker up if y'all was there.
Me with Death Row, with Suge, and all the artists on Death Row, as long as I'm staying out of trouble, I'm getting back to the community.
I want to do a real sad song, so do we have to do that from scratch, or are we going to be able to do it with that beat?
That beat? Is it sad?
Sure. I mean, I'm real sure. Sad.
Sad. We've already finished 18 songs. We're going to do a double album. That's real good. This album is more celebratory of life, upbeat, energetic, fun, I think. But it's also harsher in terms of the language because I've been in jail for 11 and a half months. I've been in jail for 11 and a half months. I wasn't about to come out and censor the thoughts that were in my head. They were like building on top of each other. I shook the world before with my anger, and now I want to shake the world with my ambition and with my love for my music and my acting and generally for my comrades.
Find out what really happened and report the story. If not, you ain't shit. You just like the rest of these bitches trying to bring me down. So that's why I curse you motherfuckers out every chance I get.
What is
Then he told Fox News producer Michelle Williams just why he's so mad.
And the way the world is today, a woman can say anything about a man, and I'm guilty until proven. You know what I'm saying? It's like I don't even have a chance. Everybody already made me guilty. My career's already going this way.
Did she lie?
Of course she lied.
Okay,
I'm an autograph. I watch rap TV. All right.
When I'm not busy signing autographs or getting phone numbers, I watch rap TV.
One more time, tell them who you are.
Well, it's Tupac when I ain't busy cool with the thug life. Doing autographs, getting numbers. I watch rap TV.